Got my first real six string, bought it at the five and dime. Played it till my fingers bled. Was a summer of 69. Me and some guys from school had a band and we tried real hard.
All right, today we are making one of my favorite entrees, something to eat. We're doing gumbo. All right. But first, on my previous episode, we talked about making a roux. We are going to make a roux, but we are going to make a dark roux. That means we're going to be cooking it. All right. So I'm using my cast iron pan. I'm using oil, and I got my flour. All right. I'm going to add about a cup of oil. All right. And then I'm going to add about a cup of flour. Now, you're cooking this, it's going to smell, and I always tell people it's going to smell like peanuts. All right. So we're going to cook it, but here's the thing. When we add it to our gumbo, I like to make this roux in advance. I like to cool it down, okay? Because then I can add it to a simmering gumbo. Once we get there, you'll see why. If you add hot roux to a gumbo, it'll break and you'll see a lot of fat surfacing. So I'm gonna add my flour and then we're gonna whisk it in. All right, remember, you can go overboard a little bit because you can always add more flour or add more oil. Right, all right, we're gonna stir that in, and I like doing it in a cast iron pan.
Oh, you bet. Oh, control. You
just because it cooks evenly more, and it can get hotter faster. Remember the consistency that we want. All right, kind of like a cream oatmeal, kind of cream of wheat. All right, there we go. Be liquid mixed in. All right, we don't want to see any white little specks. All right, there we go. And we're constantly stirring right now. So right now we got kind of like a blonde roux. See, it's a blonde roux. See that? Just constantly stirring. All right, this is going to take probably, I would say, 15 minutes to cook. We can kind of smell a little bit here. The darker the roux, the better I feel. Gives it a lot of flavor. All right. Keep stirring. As you can see, the little specks in here where it's cooking. See, it's getting a little darker. Remember this, if you get this on you, it will burn like tar. Yeah. And it's hot oil and flour. Make sure when you're stirring it that you're being safe around it and not whipping it.
And Rock was young. Me and Susie had so much fun. Holding hands and skimming stones. Had a no-gold
chair. We're going to start our prepping for our gumbo. Basically, we have onions, bell peppers, and celery, which is in New Orleans is referred to the holy trinity of vegetables for New Orleans cooking. But I'm going to be adding garlic, chicken, and sausage. Sorry, not using any shrimp or lobster. Just don't have it. So we have an abundance of chicken in the fridge, so we're going to use that. And I'm going to be throwing it in our Instapot with our chicken and sausage and cooking it through there. Not Instapotting it, but using the saute function on it, so I don't have to heat the kitchen up, my house up. So and the Instapot's pretty big, so I can cook it in there. So let's get the cutting.
Walking like a one man army, fighting with the shadows. Living out the same old moment, knowing you'd be better off instead. If you could only say what you need to say. 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 Say what you need to say.
So here's the sausage, And I am using, I froze this sausage for about an hour, so it's easier to cut. I got these sausages at Nick's. All right, so as you can see, when it's frozen, it's a lot easier. All right, so I am going to cut them just about a quarter of an inch. I'm gonna butterfly them. All right, butterfly them, and I'm gonna chunk them. You can use any chicken you want. Legs, thighs, breasts. I have breasts, so we're just gonna, just like in the restaurants with a lot of pasta dishes have shrimp with the tails on it. The only reason why it has it on the tails is for presentation. But if I did any pasta with shrimp in it, I usually took the tails out because me as a customer, I used to get mad when I had to go in there, we used my fingers to take the tails off the shrimp. Here's my Instapot. All right, I'm going to put it on saute. All right, I'm gonna start it. There we go. This is about, I think, a 4 or 5 quart pot. I'm gonna add enough oil to coat the bottom. All right, like I said, I'm not deep frying. All right, so you don't, you only need enough oil to coat the bottom. Nope. I'm sorry. What'd I do? All right, go back on. All right. So we're gonna wait for this to get hot, and we're going to start with our veggies. All right. Celery, onion, garlic, and bell peppers. All right. So with this Instapot, it doesn't take long to get hot. That's for sure. All right. So once it starts sizzling, then you go. All right. So the other thing that I am going to be using, I'm going to be using a mixture of beef base and chicken base. Well, chicken stock and beef stock. All right. And we're going to cook everything. And then we have our roux. Our roux is our last thing that we're going to add to our gumbo to thicken it. And then I'll just keep it on low and then eat after I take the dog out for a walk. All right, so now I can see a little bit of the moisture coming out of the vent. All right, so now we're gonna add our chicken. All right. Bloop. All right. Stir it in there. And we got our sausages right here already cut up. So I already had the mise en place ready. Mise en place, remember, get everything in place. All right, we're cooking everything. We don't wanna be running around, right? All right, freaking out, like, oh, I need this. But also, if you're making gumbo, I use a little gumbo file for a little seasoning. But I'm gonna add that. I add a lot of my seasonings at the end, because I can kind of, I want to taste what I have in it already, because some of the stocks and salts that I add would be a little salty. All right. I usually put okra in here. Okra helps thicken the gumbo and gives it another veggie, but I don't have any okra. So, gotta deal with what I gotta deal with in this Rona times, right? All right, so, keep cooking. As you see in this Rona times that I need a haircut, need a shave. All right, now, oh, yeah. All right. There you go. All right, now I'm gonna add some bone broth. Mm-hmm. I made about 4 cups. So. All right. Okay, now we've been simmering it. All right, so everything's cooked. Now we're gonna add our roux. All right, so here's the roux again. All right, and just give it a little stir right there. See that? All right, and you're gonna add a little bit at a time. A little bit at a time. Get your whisk, a nice glop, and stir it in. All right, stir it in. You don't want to just put it in, you want to whisk it in, okay? I know there's meat and everything in there. So get your whisk, take a little bit more, All right, stir it in. And you're going to see it thickened, okay? Especially if it's simmering, all right? You have to add a roux when it's simmering, okay? And then you can thicken it to the consistency that you want. All right. I'll just let it sit there, let it cook a little bit more, and I'll add a little bit more. All right, so I got it simmering. I put all my roux in there, all right? We want to cook the roux out now, all right? Because you don't want to serve it right after you do the roux because it's going to taste like roux. All right, so cook it for, put it on another simmer, low simmer for another 10 to 15 minutes. Right there, I'm going to add a little bit of salt and pepper, and I already added a little gumbo file. All right, if you don't have it, it's kind of hard to see, hard to find. Ah, Maverick, get off. All right, sorry, my dog's chewing on my feet. All right, put a little pepper. Mm-hmm. Stir it up and taste. So that's it. So my wife's making some white rice, because I like rice with my gumbo, and just get it and pour some rice over it. Oh, that you just can't ring. I reached out trying to love, but I feel nothing. Yeah, my heart is numb.